So the current war is finally coming out in theaters, although critics didn't really like it. Here is the Battle of Electricity explained in 3 minutes. As you may know, this is the rivalry competition between two electrical systems that could power the world in the late 19th century. The direct current, DC, from Thomas Edison versus the alternating current, AC, from George Westinghouse. While we commonly know Edison as the inventor of the light bulb, it was not exactly true because Edison actually purchased the patent from someone else and only perfected it to make the light bulb last longer. He did, however, develop the DC system, distributing electricity with his first power station in the world. Just as everything was going smoothly for Edison's company, George Westinghouse, an American entrepreneur, developed the AC system that could step up voltage for long-distance transmission and then step it back down for indoor lighting. Not only was it more efficient, it was much cheaper. This new invention soon spread across the United States, and with Edison trying to win back over the market, this marks the beginning of the current war. Westinghouse AC was ingenious, but not perfect. Although high voltage allowed the AC system to be cheap and efficient, it raises public concern for safety at the same time. Back in the days, high voltage power lines were lying all over the cities with minimum protection. In the Great Blizzard of 1888, many power lines were taken down by the snowstorm and killed a number of people with high voltage AC. This gave Edison the chance to strike back with his DC system. Unlike AC, DC was not as powerful, and Edison always insisted burying his wires underground for safety. This turns every news media against Westinghouse overnight. To knock out his opponents once and for all, Edison conducted a series of experiments using electric currents on animals. With the help of his engineers, he publicly electrocuted a bunch of stray dogs just to show that AC was much deadlier than DC. To prove his point to the legal community, he even electrocuted horses and designed the first ever electric chair to execute a criminal. At that time, Edison was basically winning because the general public either fear or resents the AC system. But even Westinghouse did not do well in his propaganda. The current war still have DC on the losing side. This is because Nikola Tesla, a former employee of Edison, invented a new AC motor and sold it to Westinghouse, allowing him to build a completely integrated AC system that was better than ever. Meanwhile, for Edison, he wasn't doing so well. Losing majority control for his company was soon merged by JP Morgan, which somehow forced Edison himself to leave the power business for good. In Chicago, 1893, Westinghouse won the bid to power the World's Columbian Exposition. In front of 27 million visitors from 46 countries, Westinghouse lit up 200 buildings with electricity, showing the world that AC power was not only better, but also cheap, efficient, and safe. After years of competition, the current war finally came to an end.